calculating compound interest using a table. Here we have our formula for calculating the compound interest. The maturity value is equal to the principal times the quantity 1 plus I, which is the interest rate per compounding period, raised to n, the number of compounding periods. Well, we can take a look at the portion being multiplied by the principal, and because those same interest rates and the same compounding periods tend to repeat themselves over and over, we can generate a table. Instead of having to calculate this each and every time, we can look those particular values up in a table. So let's take a look at how this works. We will replace this whole quantity in the shading from a value that corresponds with the interest rate per compounding period, our I, and our n, the number of compounding periods, and then multiply it by the principal. So here's the table. It's located in your textbook on page 402, and it's the replacement for the quantity 1 plus I raised to the n power. The horizontal values are the interest rate per compounding period, and the vertical axis is our number of compounding periods. And here's an example of how it works. Say we have a $750 deposit at 4% compounded annually for 3 years. If we calculate our interest rate per period and our number of compounding periods, then we can pull off the multiplier from this table. The interest rate per period would be 4% divided by 1 because of annually compounding frequency, which means we're going to look at this column. N is our number of compounding periods, 3 years times 1, since it's compounding annually, gives us 3, and where that row and column intersect gives us our multiplier. We would take our $750 times this value that's shaded here to give us our maturity value. The result ends up, after 1 year at 4% compounded annually, we would have a balance of $843.65. What if we had $750 deposited at 6%, this time compounded semi-annually for 5 years? To use the table, we need to find our I, interest rate per period, and n, the compounding periods. The I will be 6% divided by the compounding number associated with the frequency. Semi-annually means twice a year, so 6% divided by 2 is 3%. How many compounding periods are there? Well, there's 5 years times twice a year, so 5 times 2, there would be a total of 10 times that interest would be compounded and calculated, and where that row and column intersect are 3% compound interest, or interest per compound period, and the number of compounding periods is this multiplier that replaces the second half of our compound interest formula. All we need to do is multiply it by our principal to give us the total amount in the account after 5 years with these specifics, $1,007.94. In this next example, we still have the $750, but this time we have 6% compounded quarterly for 2 years. To use the table, we need to determine interest rate per compounding period, the I value, and n, the number of compounding periods. 6% compounded quarterly means we're going to take 6% and divide it by 4, the number associated with quarterly. And when you take 6% divided by 4, you get a 1.5%. So we'll use this second column with values in it. For our n, the number of compounding periods, this is being compounded for 2 years quarterly, so there would be a total of 2 times 4, or 8 compounding periods. So we'll read across that row until it intersects our column for our I. Identifying that value, we then use that value to multiply by our principal. That will give us our total amount in the account. Last example here, 12% compounded monthly for 1 year using the table. Again, we need to always find our interest rate per compounding period and the number of compounding periods. 12% compounded monthly, our I would be 12% divided by 12, since monthly there are 12 months in a year. So we'll use our 1% for our I, our N, number of compounding periods, 1 year, times 12 times per year because of the monthly, means we have a total of 12 compounding periods. Where that row and column intersect gives us our multiplier. We use that value then to multiply by our principal to give us our total amount in the account, or we call it the compound amount. This last example, we have $18,000. Can be invested at 8% compounded quarterly, and they're asking us to find the compound amount after 3 years and 9 years. To do this, we need to find our interest rate per compounding period. We have 8% compounded quarterly. 8% divided by 4 is giving us 2%. How many compounding periods will happen in 3 years? Quarterly is 4 times per year times 3 gives us 12. Looking those two values up on the table gives us the following multiplier here in blue times our principal will show that at the end of 3 years, this is what the $18,000 now is worth. What about 9 years? Well, our interest rate per compounding period isn't going to change. It's still compounding quarterly and it's still 8%, but our number of compounding periods has changed. Now we're dealing with 9 years and 4 times per year. So 9 times 4 gives us 36 compounding periods. We will look up 2% for our I and 36 for our N on the table, which should correspond to this multiplier, 2.0 and so on. Timesing it by the principal, the initial investment, results in a balance of over $36,000, almost $37,000.